Okay, next we're going to talk about the tracking mechanism in the belt tensioner section of the grinder. Got a piece of square tubing, it's 1.5 inches, 16 1/8 inches long from end to end. And this actually has a cap on the end. If you remember, there's a spring that slides into the bottom of the vertical post there, and that provides the tension for the belt. This tubing is actually relatively thin, it's 1/8 inch wall. Like I said, this is scrap that I had. You can go thicker, but it's just scrap I had, but it seemed to work better at the time. And you can see that the mechanism that the top pulley rides on is a piece of 2-inch square tubing, 1/4 inch wall. It's 3 1/4 inches long, and you can see it's just been cut at an angle. You can see that's how that looks. You can see it pivots there, and that's the tracking mechanism. I'll explain that here in a second. This hole that's drilled into the top is offset, and also it's down a little bit. The reason for that is because you really want to be able to have just a tiny bit of negative camber to have for adjustment in the belt. Otherwise, you're kind of defeating the purpose. So it's hard to kind of tell in the video, but this actually has just a tiny bit of negative tilt this way. And this is what adjusts it in and out. So this is 3/4 inch from the top and 5/8 inch from this side. This pulley, it's mounted, it's got a carriage bolt in here. You can see it's got a carriage bolt. It's rounded off a little bit to help make it seat, and actually there's a corresponding hole with a chamfer around it to help it lay as flat as possible when it's flipped down. And you can see how the tracking mechanism works. Once you turn this bolt, it just backs the threaded portion in and out, and it rides up against this. So it allows it to go ahead and adjust. And you can see how it moves it back and forth. You don't need a whole lot. The adjustment is very small. Usually it's just a couple turns. And this actually holds itself really well. There's enough tension on the belt to where this doesn't back out. The distance from the edge here to here is 5/8 of an inch. And you can see also that I had to offset the pulley here with a few washers, and that's just to provide a little bit of clearance so it spins free. And that's it for the belt tracking.